What is the standard pressure range used in control valve? Pressure is typically modulated between 20.7 to 103 kPa, 3 to 15 psi, to move the valve from 0 to 100% position. How does a control valve operate? To function, the control valve requires a signal from a controller like a PLC or ADCs. The controller compares the actual flow rate to the set point, which is the desired flow rate. To bring the flow rate to the set point value, the controller will produce an output to move the valve. How do valves control pressure? These valves counteract secondary circuit pressure with an adjustable spring that tries to open the valve. When the pressure in the secondary circuit falls, spring force opens the valve sufficiently to increase pressure and maintain a constant reduced pressure in the secondary circuit. Why we use 3 to 15 psi air for control valve input? It appears 3 to 15 psi with the 1:5 ratio was chosen because it the most linear portion on the curve for the movement of the flapper, baffle, and the back pressure resulting in the nozzle. Which valve is used for control valve? Globe valves are normally used for control, and their ends are usually flanged for ease of maintenance. Depending on their type of supply, the disc is moved by a hydraulic, pneumatic, electrical or mechanical actuator. Why does control valve operate at PSI? On higher pressure, the actuator sizes becomes bigger in area. The actual force produced by the actuator. Force is equal to pressure asterisk area. Is equal to 15 psi asterisk area. If area is equal to 15, force produced is equal to 15 psi asterisk 25 into is equal to 375 pounds. Actual force acting on a control valve is equal to 375 pounds. An operator tells you that a control valve in a stuck. How will you start checking? First of all, get the control valve is passed from operation. Check the lingual to the diaphragm of the control valve. Disconnect it possible the actuator stem from the control valve stem. Stroke the actuator and see whether the actuator operates or not. If not, then the diaphragm may be punctured. If the actuator operates, connect it back to the plug stem, stroke the control valve. If it doesn't operate, loosen the gland nuts a bit and see if it operates. If it does not, then the control valve has to be removed from the line to workshop. How will you select the control valve characteristics? The graphic display of flow various lift shows then the desired or inherent characteristic is changed by variations pressure drop. This occurs as the process changes from condition where most of pressure drop takes place at the control valve is a condition where most of the pressure drop is generally distributed through rest of the system. Percent flow. This variation in where most of the total drop take place is one of the most important aspects is choosing the proper valve characteristics for give process. Flow control, normally equal percentage valve is used. Pressure control, normally linear valve is used to maintain a constant pressure drop. Temperature control, normally equal percentage valve is used. Liquid level control. Normally linear valve is used. Basically, in selecting a valve characteristic, two important point have to be taken into account. There should be a linear relationship between the position of the plug and the flow through the valve in a wide range of change in the pressure drop across the valve. The pressure drop across a valve should be as low as possible. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, comment. IIQA.